Hello everyone, welcome to Mom Star series. In this series we welcome our awesome mothers who are exclusively breastfeeding their babies, and to just honor them, because breastfeeding is not easy. It may sound like it is a natural process and it is something which a mother has to do or something like that, but believe me, it is not easy. It takes lot of courage and lots of motivation to keep moving in the journey of breastfeeding. So this series is to honor the mothers who are exclusively breastfeeding their babies. So today we have Mrs. Kritika Shriram from Chennai, who took online counseling with me for breastfeeding counseling, and now she is a proud mother and she is doing exclusive breastfeeding for her baby. Welcome, Kritika.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so Kritika, can you please tell us in brief about yourself?
Okay, I completed my engineering in 2013, and then I worked in an IT firm for 3 years during when I got married. And because of the marriage life and, you know, the work being very hectic, then I had to quit my job. And then I was kind of like interested to work with children. So I completed my Montessori diploma, and then I worked as a Montessori teacher for 2 years before going to abroad to be with my husband.
Okay. So
that's briefly about me.
That's great. Good to know about you, because during the counseling and out, we get less time to know each about each other. So now it is the time when we can like know more about each other.
Yes.
Okay, good. So I would like to ask you, what was your biggest challenge in breastfeeding journey?
Many things. I don't know where to begin, actually. The first one was like, I thought I had low supply. That was my major issue.
Yes, every time we had the same discussion.
Yes. So like what happened, like the reason why I thought this was because of the events that happened after childbirth. I was totally not prepared for breastfeeding. I thought that's something that comes very naturally for a mother, so I need not know anything about it. And in fact, I did attend some the pre-pregnancy classes, but they were mostly concentrating only on exercises for normal delivery. Mm-hmm. So they didn't really kind of like, I did have a session on breastfeeding, but the lady who took that session was like very fast. She just said like 2 bullet points you have to remember: if breastfeeding is painful, you're not doing it right, and you have to take nipple and the areola inside. That's it. So she didn't tell anything about like how to latch the baby, like, and nothing, like the different positions of latching, nothing was told. So I thought, okay, this is more than sufficient for me. And that's how I was totally unprepared for breastfeeding. And what happened, like on the third day, my son got jaundice. So when I was admitted in hospital, I came to know that happens because your baby is not having enough milk. So it could either be because the mother's having a low supply, or it is because the baby is not latching properly. So I had both.
Okay.
So that was the major issue for which I had consulted you. And because of that, what happened in the hospital, they asked me to start top feeds. So because of that, I started giving top feed, thinking like, okay, but somewhere I knew I was not doing right. I wanted to exclusively breastfeed my child right from when I was pregnant. I was planning I have to do exclusive breastfeeding. But then when they told like you have to give, you are having low supply, you have to give formula milk, I believed in those doctors. And I started giving top feeds. And somewhere I was feeling very guilty on doing that as well. But then I had no other choice, because I can't let my baby cry.
Yes.
And I can't starve him. So I thought, okay, whatever I'm doing, I thought, okay, this is what it is, like, it's done. Like, my breastfeeding journey is done. So this is like, okay, you have to go with the top feeds only. So that's when I got your contact through the Facebook group. Actually, I had attended your smart parenting session once.
Yes, during the lockdown, I used to take a lot of sessions. I think that time you attended.
Yes, I attended the session actually. But then after that, I completely forgot about you, ma'am. Actually, just skipped off my mind. And then suddenly one day when I was sitting and looking at the mobile phone, I saw in that smart parenting group, like your broadcast message coming. Like, I do online counseling for breastfeeding issues. And that's when I thought, okay, I'll get in touch with ma'am. Let's see if she can get me back on breastfeeding.
Okay, good. Good to know. So that is the right time when I messaged, I think. Otherwise, you would have missed that.
Yeah.
Okay. So now please share your breastfeeding journey with us.
The first time when I tried to contact you, I was a little hesitant because here I met with a lactation consultant before contacting you, and that lady was kind of a little rude. So I was like a little scared, like, no, what if I face something?
One more mother told me, I was little hesitant to contact you because you are a doctor. So I thought you will be like other doctors who will not listen to me. They will just counsel and they will just leave. So
yeah.
Okay.
So something like that, like she started scolding me. So I was like little hesitant, why is she doing this? So I was like, what if Tanima ma'am also does that? So I was little scared to call you first. But then when I contacted you the first time itself, I liked how patiently like you took notes, like you said, okay, this could be because of the latching issue. Let me send you videos. You can, you know, like look at the videos and try to latch your baby. And, you know, like sometimes you can record the video and send me. And we'll do a follow-up for the 7 days. That was something that I got really impressed with. Because generally, like, when this, the other person whom I met, she just, like, saw me only for that one day and then she just forgot. And even I'm trying to fix up appointment, she's like, I'm busy, I don't have appointments and stuff like that. So amongst them, like, you took time to, you know, like, help me out with the breastfeeding journey. You understood my problem. First of all, you spoke very softly. That is something that gave me a lot of confidence in breastfeeding. And you always used to tell that the mother's confidence is the thing that helps in breastfeeding.
Yes, that I even feel it is always. When a mother is confident, she will give her 100%. When she doesn't have any doubt, okay, I have started asking mothers to write down the positive affirmations and then repeating it every day. Because that gives lots of mental stamina to you. In that way.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, in fact, even after having your sessions with you also, somewhere in the middle, again, I kind of went to top feed and again we had
You told me. That's why it's like, so important to keep in touch and just to keep asking. And that's why I always send follow-up messages also. It is not, it is never like I don't send follow-up. And I have always told my assistant to keep sending these messages because I know my mothers, they will just feel that, okay, now the things are not moving correct. So I must give this, I must give that. So just keep them on the track.
So that's what, again, we had a session and then you told me like, no, your mindset is what matters. You have to be positive. You have milk. You have to think you have milk. You have to give milk. Only if you give, it will grow. So, and then you also gave me tips on pumping. The thing was like, I bought a pump, I didn't know how to use it. I was using it like in stupid ways I can think of. So you guided me on how to correctly use the pump to help me increase my supply. So all those things was like really helpful. And thank you so much. If you had not guided me that time, then I don't know. Maybe I would have like just...
So my son just came and say hello.
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 Okay, fine. So my next question is, so how was your experience with me? Like how I could help you or something like that. Can you please let me?
Actually, the biggest support I got from you, more than the process, was the mental support. Or, you know, the confidence that you were always telling, like, there were many times when I thought, no, I'm done. I'm not going to breastfeed my child anymore. Because that frustration.
I remember Andy also, your mother, who you both used to have so many questions. So, but I knew that she can do it. She's just having that doubt. Otherwise, she will be doing. And I saw that support system at your home. Your mother, she was such a good support. She's such a good support system. So I knew that only she needs some mental counseling. And as she will be done, she will be able to do it. Yes. I think once we had a talk for around 1 hour also.
Yes, ma'am.
Because after that, I was thinking, Baba, how much I talk to her. She would be thinking, Baba, how much he talks. And I was thinking, okay, it's okay. But because that counseling is very important for her.
Yes.
And I could see that active involvement of your mother also. Because when I can see that, okay, from one side that involvement is there, then I never give, like, I am never going back. Then I give more than required at that time. Because I know she can do that.
Yes.
That time. Yes.
Yeah, actually, my mom has been a pillar of support for breastfeeding.
Yes.
If she was not there, then I would have definitely stopped. Mm-hmm. Even with your advice, if she didn't stand so strong on me telling, no, you have to breastfeed. If you give only, you'll get milk.
Yes.
So, and then she also she looked up on recipes to increase milk. So she tried lot giving a lot of galactagogues to me. So that way also she helped me a lot. So and sometimes whenever I used to feel down, she'll be like, "No, it's, I know motherhood is tough, but you have to face
And
it."
once also she counseled me, like she was talking to me that please you counsel Kritika, I think she's just having tension right now and she will listen to you, please you talk to her once. And I was feeling so good that a mother is telling to me please counsel my daughter because I think she will listen to you for that. So I was feeling so blessed, at least a mother, at least she feels so confident that her daughter is in a safer hands with me. So I
Yes.
felt so good that time, that way.
Actually,
And
sometimes, ma'am, I also used to feel little angry on you. Like when you're not there, this used to happen. Like I used to be like, ma'am, just ऐसे ही के बोलती रहती है हमेशा, बेबी को ब्रेस्ट मिलो, बेबी को ब्रेस्ट मिलो. मुझे तो, मैं थक गई हूँ, मैं नहीं लूंगी.
I understand, but now see, you are already demotivated, and then if I also say okay, leave it, then obviously we
तो
are all gone.
फिर
So we have to do
हाँ,
that
तो मम्मी वो ही शी यूज्ड टू टेल लाइक, नहीं तुम करो, मैम जो बोल रही करो
way.
करो, वो होगा
And
तो
it is not
करो.
like with everyone, where I see that okay, it is not there, then I don't push. For you, I was seeing that it has all happened, it is all there, and she's just not able to do that. So that's why I was pushing you there. Otherwise, sometimes when I feel the milk supply is less and the baby is also not latching, then sometimes I don't push that much. But for you, I was just feeling that right now only mental support is required for her. Everything was good. Your baby's weight gain was good. Everything was good.
Yes.
Again, the same thing. I'm not having milk. I'm not having milk. So that's
Yes,
why I
ma'am.
was
Actually,
there.
right now only realize, like, because now since I'm pumping a lot, so I'm able to see my milk output, what's coming. I know that is not the actual output that you should think, but I could see that it's gradually increasing day by day. So that's when I really started getting confidence on breastfeeding. Okay. So because my biggest concern was people around me always used to tell, like, I used to leak when I feed my child. My breast used to be very heavy.
Strips, that streams of milk,
Yeah, streams of milk,
streams of milk,
sprays,
sprays.
and stuff like that, and nothing of those happened to me right from day one. So that also kind of like added on. Oh my God, really? I think I'm not having milk supply, because that is okay. People having oversupply have that.
But that is a very lesser amount of people. We should not, and this is everything different. Every mother is different. Every baby is different. So that may be the reason that they are not latching properly, that they are not able to give that milk to the baby and it is coming out in streams. That can
Yeah,
also happen now. So
that's what, like, you always used to tell me that, and that's what I was also thinking. Maybe, yeah, okay, ma'am always used to tell, maybe the baby is not latching correctly, that's why they're having so much of milk leakage.
obviously the when the milk is not when the baby is not able to have the milk, then milk will leak. So that way, I meant to say, like, different kind of stories might be there. We can't compare ourselves to anybody into that.
True, yes.
Until unless our baby's weight gain is good, then what is the thing? Main thing is baby's weight gain, and your baby's weight gain was good. So we didn't have all these kind of issues that time. So it was just to just keep you on the track. Just keep moving, just keep moving. You are doing good. Just keep moving into that. And one more thing I would also like to sell. Sometimes what happens when the mothers reach out, they just feel ki some magical things will happen. And within 4 5 days, I'll just get good milk, my babies, everything will be fine. But it is always, you have to remember that you have to keep consistent, you have to be patient. And I remember, Kritika, it was not like we were not able to finish everything in 1 week. I think
Yes.
we took around 2 weeks or 3 weeks to finish up the whole thing. I
No,
remember
I
two.
think we finished it in 1 week, but I took 2 sessions, like 2 1-week sessions. Yeah.
Okay, I think to just clear it out, like
Yeah,
other
clear
things
it
and
out.
all that,
Yeah,
no?
yeah.
Yes.
Like first I took for a week, and then like after 2 3 weeks, again I had the issue. And you remember, we talked for an hour. Again, it started
Okay,
giving
that was the second
problems.
time.
That was the
Okay.
second time
So
I got.
actually, I would like to tell the viewers it is a long, like around 3 4 months have passed, so we have just missed out the things. So right now your baby is how many months now?
He's 5 months old, ma'am. He's
5 months.
entering
And
his
I think
sixth
we
month.
started with 1 month when the baby was 1 month or something,
Yes,
no?
yes. 1 month.
That's why. Okay, so it is nice journey. It is so good to now speak about all those things, and when we at
Yes.
that time were struggling, and now we are laughing on those things. And that time
Yes,
it was
ma'am.
so tension. Kritika
Yeah.
was always so tense. There was always a question mark on her face and all that.
true, ma'am. That is very true. Now, if I think back, I'm like, oh my God, I need not have reacted so much for this.
No, but that's okay. We'll
Yeah, I mean,
help
first time
you.
mom, so
Yeah,
unexpected
correct,
things.
correct. Now, I want to ask you about two kind of people. We have expectant mothers who are pregnant, and we have mothers who have delivered and are facing some difficulty. So
Okay.
first, I would like to ask you what message you want to give to the expectant mothers, like who are pregnant right now.
For them, I would say, like, if possible, like, go for a good breastfeeding counseling session even before you deliver your baby, because breastfeeding doesn't come so easily. Maybe in olden days it was coming very easily, but with today, the situation is like all of us are in a lot of stress. Like, I was in a lot of stress. Even during my pregnancy, I had gestation diabetes and stuff like that going on. So I was always stressed, even during my pregnancy. So nowadays, I feel like the breastfeeding is not coming very naturally as it was in the olden days to newer mother, because of the lifestyle changes, the stress, the pollution levels, everything that's there. So please don't miss breastfeeding session. And even if you're the person whom you're attending the classes with breastfeeding is not clear, go behind them. Like, ask them, like, no, give me videos. Like, how do you do this? How do you do that? I didn't do that, basically. So maybe if I had done that, and like I also didn't know terms like cluster feeding, and like hind milk, foam milk, none of these I knew. I was not even prepared for all these things, because initially when the baby cries a lot, he's always on the breast, means it's like cluster feeding. I didn't know that because nobody told me that. And when baby is constantly on your breast,
So
people
I would
around
like
you
to give
say,
you a good news about this, that I am taking sessions for pregnant ladies also for breastfeeding.
okay.
So that is a like because I have when I have talked to so many mothers, I felt that these people need the information. So it is now like mothers can join who are pregnant, they can also reach out, and I'll give the class for them also now. That's I'm taking in a 1 hour session. I'm just teaching them all the basics about it.
Yes, because I didn't know all those things. That was also one of the reasons that I thought I had a low supply.
Huh.
Because when the baby is all constantly on your breast, then people around you start telling, like, maybe तुम्हें दूध नहीं है, दूध
Yes.
कम है,
No.
इसलिए बच्चा इतनी देर दूध पी रहा है. तो ऑल दोस थिंग्स ऑल्सो लाइक काइंड ऑफ लाइक एडेड अप, बिकॉज आई वॉज टोल्ड आई वॉज प्रेगनेंट.
And also because it is very tiring for the mother also when the baby latches for the whole day and the baby's clinging on you and all that. So if you know the right latching techniques, that will not take too much of the time in the breastfeeding and all that. And
Exactly.
one more thing, during pregnancy, if they know what has to be done on day one, if you are having cesarean also, because nowadays cesarean rates are too high. So if the mother knows from day one how she can latch the baby when she's lying straight also, do you think that will bring more success to us? Because
Yes.
baby will be there from first day itself. That half an hour, that is the golden hour when the baby has to be latched. And people don't know about that. So if they know about that during their pregnancy, they can talk to their doctor about that.
Yes.
I want my baby to be latched on the breast within half an hour. And if the mother start demanding that, then obviously doctors will also go for it. Yeah.
Because
So,
I didn't know all those things, and none of those happened with me. So
Yes.
that was the first thing that I missed out on, because I was never informed on all these things.
Yes. Now, if you knew about this, that this is something called as golden hour. And
Huh.
I because now I am telling everyone that go
Yes.
and speak to your doctor about it, that I want my baby to be latched in the golden hour. So that will obviously when the patient, the mother is asking the doctor, then obviously doctor will take that thing into consideration. And then
Yes.
when the baby is latched on in the golden hour, that will bring lot of success in the breastfeeding, and we don't
True.
have to keep the baby on the formula because and also she when she will be told that colostrum amount is sufficient for the baby, those 50, like 5-10 ml is sufficient for the baby. When she knows that, then obviously she'll be giving her best into that. So
Yes.
this should be known in
Yes.
their pregnancy itself.
Yes,
Okay.
ma'am.
And what message you want to give to the fellow mothers? That is very important.
For fellow mothers, actually, I myself have recommended like two, three people to you, ma'am, because I knew I saw the messages in our, we have a group of friends. So when we saw messages like I'm giving top feed to my child, then I knew I had a good experience with you. So I told them, like, please get in touch with a good lactation consultant. I know one, so I'm just sharing you her number. So I think that's why they got in touch with you.
Yes, you had suggested some, and some I've taken, and even they are very successful. And yes, soon I will be taking a Momstar series with them also.
Yes. So, like, that's what, like, don't feel shy. I know breastfeeding nowadays is not very easy, and that's a very taboo topic. Nobody, even not even your mother, knows it.
Yes.
Nowadays. Mm-hmm. So initially, for a mother, for a daughter, like, whenever she has doubts, she turns to her mother. But the problem is, even the mother doesn't know. Like, unka zamane mein, it all came easily for them. They were like, haan, maine aise kiya, maine doodh diya, maine bachche ko utha ke rakh liya, usne doodh pee liya.
See, one more thing was there. So, that time, these options were not available, formulas and all that.
Haan.
So, they didn't have much option into that. They had to give breastfeed. Nowadays, It is very easy for us to switch to formula or any kind of milk, because that is easily available for us. So, it takes a lot of courage, like, lot of motivation to keep moving in the breastfeeding. And that time, if you are not getting the right support and everybody around you starts telling that you don't have milk, then obviously you will get demotivated.
Yes.
So that is why a right support system is very important.
Very true, ma'am. Very true. If you don't have right support system, like if you have people telling like you don't have milk, just cut them out of your life.
Yes.
Don't talk to them again.
True. At least for some time.
At least for some time, yes. I feel you, like, at least like till 6 months, like you have to be very much determined, because breastfeeding is hard. It is hard. And it involves a lot of work.
Yes.
So it was not like something very easy. Mm. Like, I thought it would be a natural, but you have to put in a lot of effort and you'll have to have a lot of determination. And if you have problems, like, don't hesitate. Feel free to contact a lactation consultant. They are there for you. They are there to help you achieve your breastfeeding journey. So,
and nowadays, awareness is coming up. This is good that mothers have started realizing. And I always say that the mothers who have taken counseling with me or with others, they are the front army people. Now they will pass on that information to others. I always say, when I named this Maa Care Foundation or Maa Care Clinic, so it was like caring like a mother. So Maa. So you all are the Maa's now. Now you are the Maa's of the other upcoming mothers who have small babies, and they should get liquid gold from their mothers.
Yes. No, actually, like, I'm feeling so confident. Like, if somebody comes and asks me tips on breastfeeding, like, I'm confident to give them, because I've done it. Yes. I've done it, I've tested it, and it's working. So I can now confidently give them, like, okay, you do this, this will work out. Do that, this will work out.
Yes. That's great. So I will be taking help from you sometimes for counseling some mothers, because sometimes, you know, techniques are told to them, but they just need that kind of support. That is why I just made this Momstar series. So that mothers, obviously, they're honored, and that is a motivation for the other mothers also, who can see that those series, those videos, so that they also know that it is not like it was an easy journey for them. They also went through the same journey which I am going through. And when they could achieve it, even I can achieve that.
Yes.
So that is the main reason of forming this series and making the videos like this and talking to the mothers about their challenges and how they achieved it. That is the reason. Okay, just one more thing. One last thing. Like, what kept you going? Other than your mother and other than my support system, what was the thing which kept you moving?
For me, I would say to some extent my determination. Whenever, like, I used to give formula feed, you know, like, I never gave it with full heart. Like, I used to feel a lot of guilt when I was giving him the formula. So whenever, like, I thought, no, I'm going to stop breastfeeding, so I would think about that guilt which I had in the initial days when I was giving him the formula. So that guilt kept me.
Okay, so girls, listen what she said just now. I'm just repeating it again. So obviously no mother feels good when she's giving up a formula. But then this feeling, just remember this feeling. And once you start breastfeeding your baby, always make yourself remember that feeling which you had while you were giving formula to your baby. So that's what Kritika was trying to tell. So I'm just repeating it again so that you can focus on that point. So if you had a bad feeling, or you are having a bad feeling about, you're feeling guilty about giving formula, and if you are able to have a successful breastfeeding and you feel demotivated that time, please remember this feeling that time. That will keep you moving.
Yes.
That's a great advice, Kritika, because
Thank you.
this was different, because this only a mother can tell me, can tell who has been through that journey.
Yes, because every time, whenever I felt, to be honest, like there have been situations where I thought I will stop breastfeeding. Now I can't do it anymore. And even like people around my house, they said like it's up to you. It's like your convenience. Even though my mother was supporting for breastfeeding, but ultimately she said like you have to be happy. So if you feel like breastfeeding is stressful for you, it's okay, you can stop it. But then whenever I used to think like next feed I'm going to give top feed. This used to happen. Because I'm so done with him now, the next week I'm going to give him top feed. So what happens when he'll be sleeping, I'll sit and think about that guilt I got in the first month when I was giving him. So next time when he gets up, I'll automatically put him to my breast. I'll not give, think about the children,
That's
think about the
great.
top feed.
That's great. That shows that you are how well determined you are and how strong-headed you are. That's so nice. I'm so proud of you,
Thank you.
Kritika. Okay, girl. So I hope today you have got your vitamin dose of just keep moving on the success stories of breastfeeding, and you would have got good tips from Kritika. And so we both are all here. All the community of Momstars and other mothers are all here to help you out. So whoever is watching right now this movie, this video, and you feel that you are having some difficulty in your breastfeeding journey, please contact us. We will try to help you with the best of our knowledge and best of our support system. Yes, Kritika,
Yes,
we
ma'am.
will do it. We
Yes.
will just get all the babies to breastfeed their mothers and all the mothers to breastfeed their babies.
Yes,
This is our main mission to the
ma'am.
that. Okay, thank you so much, Kritika, for joining us and sharing
Thank
your journey
you.
with us. Thank you so much.
Yes, ma'am. You're
Take
welcome.
care.
Thank you.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.